Determine the first five terms of the sequence if a sub 1, the first term, equals negative 9, and d, the common difference, equals 4. Because we're given the common difference, d equals 4, we know we have an arithmetic sequence. And again, we're trying to find the first five terms. We have the first term, second term, third term, fourth term, and fifth term. We assume the sequence continues, where the first term is a sub 1, second term is a sub 2, followed by a sub 3, a sub 4, and a sub 5. And we're given a sub 1 equals negative 9, which is the first term. From here, because we know we have an arithmetic sequence and the common difference d equals 4, to get a sub 2, we add 4 to negative 9. And then we add 4 to a sub 2 to find a sub 3. We add 4 to a sub 3 to find a sub 4. And we add 4 to a sub 4 to determine a sub 5. Negative 9 plus 5 is, negative 9 plus 4 is negative 5. Negative 5 plus 4 is negative 1. Negative 1 plus 4 is 3. 3 plus 4 is 7. These are the first five terms of the given arithmetic sequence. If we look at the formulas in the upper right-hand corner, what we just did is we applied the formula a sub n equals a sub n minus 1 plus d, which is true for any arithmetic sequence. Taking a closer look at this formula is telling us to find any term in an arithmetic sequence given by a sub n. We take the term before it given by a sub n minus 1 and add the common difference d, which is what we did to determine a sub 2 through a sub 5. I also want to mention we could have found the formula for any term in the arithmetic sequence, which is a sub n equals a sub 1 plus the quantity n minus 1 times d, and use this formula to find each of the four terms. It would have taken more time and more effort, but it would have also worked. Let's show how we would set up this formula. We would have a sub n equals a sub 1, which is given as negative 9, plus the quantity n minus 1 times the common difference d, which is 4. Simplifying, we have a sub n equals negative 9 plus 4n minus 4, giving us a sub n equals negative 13 plus 4n. The benefit of this formula is that we don't need the previous term to determine any of the terms in the arithmetic sequence. Just as an example, if we want to find a sub 4, when determining a sub 4, notice n is equal to 4, we know a sub 4 is equal to negative 13 plus 4 times 4, which is negative 13 plus 16, which equals positive 3, which we can see below is correct. So the power of this formula is we can find any term in the arithmetic sequence, again, without knowing the previous term. Either way, we now know the first five terms of the arithmetic sequence are negative 9, negative 5, negative 1, 3, and 7. I hope you found this helpful.